said, what I think separated Zacchaeus from God was prejudice and the church. The church didn't welcome him in because he was a tax collector. He wasn't just a tax collector. He was a really, really good tax collector. He was a chief tax collector, which is sort of like being at the top of a Ponzi scam. Rome would sell the right to be a tax collector or a chief tax collector to a wealthy bidder who was Jewish. And basically, by doing that, you're kind of selling out your people. So you take, you buy your place in it, and if you were a chief tax collector, you would have underlings that worked for you, and they would collect taxes, and every tax they would collect, there'd be a kickback that went to the chief tax collector. There were several different kinds of taxes. There was taxes for roads, there was taxes on tariffs on things. There were so many different kinds of taxes, and the tax collector could set the tax amount. There was the amount that Rome demanded, and then whatever over it was how they made their living. And so the chief tax collector not only collected a portion from everybody else's overages, but also whatever he collected on his own. So it was opportunity, and they said that he was really good at it. He was rich. So he made himself rich on the backs of other people's tax burdens. And he was conspiring with Rome. So he was low. He had no place. But there's an interesting thing in the story. There's more to him than what everybody sees. And how many times have you been in a relationship with or come across somebody who you cannot see differently than when they first broke your heart? The alcoholic, the addict, the gambler, the troublemaker, the person that wronged you. Think of all the different ways that somebody in your life has been unable to shape the way that you first viewed them or the way that you viewed them when they were at their lowest. How many times have you failed to be able to seek and serve Christ, to see the face of God in another person, no matter how hard they may be trying to change that? How many times have you failed to see the dignity, to honor the dignity? Really getting personal here. How often have we reveled in the folly of other people? Zacchaeus was a tax collector. He was a broken guy. He made his deal with the devil. But here's something that's different about the reading and what we get when we read it. It's the only time in Luke's gospel that they use the present future tense, or the present perfect tense, and they put it in future. Because it makes for a better story. Jesus comes in, and only when Jesus acknowledges the personhood of Zacchaeus and invites him down is he contrite and decides to change his ways and give away half his wealth. But the more accurate reading of this is that it was already happening, that Zacchaeus was already in that process of reconciling his life, trying to fix the things that separated from God. He already was giving away half of his wealth. He already was trying to take the people that he wronged and pay it back fourfold. But the church still saw him as a tax collector. The people, even when Jesus brought him down from the tree, still saw him as a tax collector. Jesus saw him for who he really was. Even if he was still a tax collector, Jesus saw the image of God within him. And when he called him down, they said, what is Jesus doing? He's a sinner. He's worthless. Why is Jesus inviting him to dine with him? Why is he going to his house? He's a broken man. Remember that word respect. We put on different glasses. We see again with God's glasses. And how often have we failed to be able to put on that new set of glasses? But every single time we gather together, we have the opportunity to change those glasses. Acknowledge where we fail to see Christ in another person, where we fail to honor the dignity, and before we receive that wonderful gift that's poured out for us, whether we're deserving of it or not, whether we're broken or not, we have the acknowledgement that God asks and demands of us and forgives us for the falling short of it, but finding the dignity and the Christ within all of us. And then we gather as the body of Christ. The world needs the church as desperately now as it ever has. Be a group of people that walk outside these doors drinking richly from the grace of God as the body of Christ, wearing the lenses of Christ, finding wholeness and goodness in the people outside these doors. So it's not quite the convenient stewardship sermon that maybe I was hoping it was a few weeks ago. But I think there are a couple messages. One, Zacchaeus begins his transformation by starting to lead the way, by putting his money where his mouth is, by bending his life towards God. And Jesus sees Zacchaeus for who he really was, a beloved child of God, a broken, flawed child of God, the one working his tail off to bend his life towards God, to make up for the wrongs he's done, to be able to see, to be seen differently, to have the church or God honor the person that he is, to have restoration. How much do all of us desire that? To see ourselves, to be seen by others the way that God sees us. That's our work. And it takes money. And it takes our time. It takes our willingness to really dig deep, acknowledge where we've fallen short, and proclaim again and again, and with God's help, we'll see through.